to God himself, our love light and life. Has ever left him with him. But self's perseverance, your own wants and desires them by the flesh, that same. Used as an idol, sin, lie, our death and darkness forever by and from them. Romans 5. Therefore, since we have justified through faith in God, we have peace. The fruit of the Spirit, Galatians 5:22-26, God's love is joy, etc., with God himself too. And our Lord Jesus Christ, through whom we have gained access by faith in God, to this grace in which we now stand. And we rejoice in the hope of the glory of God. Not only so, but we also rejoice in our suffering. I bear my body the marks of Jesus, Galatians 6:17, born through him. Righteously, because we know that suffering produces perseverance in it through God himself. Our love, life, and light. Perseverance, character, like him spiritually, righteously, truthfully, and character, hope in him. And hope does not disappoint us. Because God himself has poured out us his love in our hearts by and through the Holy Spirit of God himself, whom he has given us since we have now been justified away from his blood prayed. Given him our sins and idols, lies, and let them die on his cross. Now love, sir. Worship him, his words of truth, to live for his virtue, righteous truthfully. How much more shall we be saved for unto him? God's wrath, anger to him. As his righteous and faithful, when we were God's enemy, sins, idols, lies, we were reconciled to him, praying, given our sins and idols, lies, and let them die. Death of his son Jesus Christ, having been reconciled, shall we be saved through his life for unto him. Not only so, but we also rejoice in God through our Lord Jesus Christ, through whom we have now received reconciliation after the believing through God's friendly relationships with one another and brotherly love, God's love. To send men to death, self-perseverance to death eternally by and from them, but through righteousness, God's perseverance for unto him. Our love, life, light, is in him forever and eternal with God himself. Amen.
Every word is a promise you keep. snow and freezing rain and a whole bunch of stuff. Wednesday, I think, or Thursday or something. Oh my goodness, I hope not, not yet. But it is almost November, and well, we gotta expect that, huh? Sooner or later, amen. So I'm gonna enjoy the riverfront as much as I can, the outdoors. So excuse my, I just left the gym. I was in the lazy river for over an hour and a half. I was just enjoying it so much, I didn't want to get out. It was nice and peaceful, amen. There was probably nobody in there. But anyway, hey to everyone, I'm Pastor Marsha, Los Fish, the River Plex, Brother, Sister Christ Jesus. It's a little cooler today, so I have to at least have a jacket on, amen. And my hair's still down, so excuse me there. I want to enjoy, like I said, the outdoors before winter hits, amen there. Anyway, and I left my other sports water bottle at my oldest son's house Thursday, so I got my smaller one, so. Anyway, at least I got one, amen. I gotta drink water. Worship him and live your life going through him. Amen. Do you have his love, life, and light? And you also got to say and do the right things going through him, his right ways and choices going through him. Amen. Amen. They are eternal within him forever. Amen. Yeah, I remember that. You Google life here. Amen. Amen. Okay. Self's perseverance is death or God's life. Perseverance going through God himself is love, light, and life. That's everlasting with him. To love, serve, and worship. But self's perseverance, your own wants and desires, done by the flesh, that saying, used as an idol, 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 saying, lie, or death and darkness forever buying from them. Romans 5, therefore, since we are justified through faith, faith, faith in God, amen, we have peace, the fruit of the Spirit, Galatians 5:26, God's love, peace, joy, etc., with God himself, through our Lord Jesus Christ, through whom we have gained access by faith, faith, faith in God, and to the good grace in which we now stand. And we rejoice in the hope of the glory of that God, amen. Not only so, but we also rejoice in our suffering. We do, we rejoice in our suffering. I bear in mind by the marks of Jesus, Galatians 5:6:17, for unto him righteously. Because we know that suffering, suffering produces perseverance, and through God himself our love, life, and light. Perseverance, character, like him, spiritual, righteously, and truthfully, and character, hope, and him, and hope does not disappoint us. No, it does not. Because God himself has poured out on us his love, yes, he did, in our hearts, by and through the Holy Spirit, Holy Spirit, Holy Spirit of God himself, whom he has given us since we have now been justified by his blood. Pray and give him our sins and our lives and let them die on his cross completely. Now let's worship him, and his words are true to live for and through spiritual righteously and truthfully. How much more shall we be saved for and through him from God's wrath, anger, through him as is righteous and faithful? First, when we were God's enemy, when we had loved and served our sins, idols, and lies, we were reconciled to him, prayed and given him our sins and our lives, and let them die now. Through death of his son, Jesus Christ, having been reconciled, shall we be saved through his life, born through him, yes. Not only so, but also we rejoice in God through our Lord Jesus Christ, through whom we have now received reconciliation, actions of believing through God's friendly relations with one another, and brotherly love, God's love. Just as sins reigns in death, selves perseverance, death eternally buying from them. God's perseverance born through him, our love, life, and light. Within in him, our eternal home with God himself forever. So remember that, amen. The wind's blowing a little bit, but it's coming from that way. Hope it doesn't go around my car, amen. It's not windy, real windy like it was 2 weeks ago, amen. Okay, right now, be purified from your sins. Christ Jesus by and from his loving and serving him and his words of truth. Subscribe to righteousness, which is saying, do the right things, flowing through your choices, truthfully and light. To live for him there, that's in our royal eternal home within him forever. Amen. So ask yourself, who, what are you master buying from? Who, what are you master buying from? Well, it's a truthful and logical question. And it's truthful, where will you end buying from? Whoever, whatever you think about. From the second you get up until you go to bed, it's truly who or what has you, will you end buying from between live life with God and God himself. In our royal eternal home, or in our darkness and death forever, but that are sinful and idolaters. We in the death and darkness forever by and from them. So remember that no wonder thing comes before God himself, as I've been teaching you. Or you're an idol, terse, sin, and liar. You're truly dying, and darkness has you worldly like them. And their words of lies, ways, and way of possessions and pleasures, and you crave and lust for more. Yes, you do. Your master buying from to lust, serve, and live your life for and doing choices, the wrong ones. It's the wrong choices, and you haven't learned anything about God and his words and ways, amen, and choices, the right ones. And you crave and lust for more, you never get enough of, that's right, your own wants and desires, that saying ends, dies forever, and thirst deaths forever. But when you put God himself first to lust, serve, master, by and from, and best friend, he's our best friend, yes, he is, that's an undying love. As he first loved us to live on through spiritual truth, being right, choose your choices, the right ones, and dying, undying life. Temple, treasures, that's the way turning with God himself, amen. And said, don't think you are a Christian, buying from going to church or reading the Bible and still sin and use idols, lies, like them, saying, doing them. You have to totally stop doing them and saying them, their lies, and give them to Jesus Christ, pray and let them die completely on his cross. Now, lesser, to serve, worship, to live born through spiritual righteous truth, and he is. Two words, language, and wise, and what you're saying to the right choices and words. Walk, talk, say, and do in heart and in mind, his love and mind to think and do and be like Jesus now and throughout eternity with Jesus Christ himself and home. And then you are a true Christian and disciple of Jesus Christ. Amen. There, okay, now this is the Bible verse. Psalm 107:1, give thanks and prayer to the Lord, for he is good, his love endures forever. So remember that, pray and give him thanks to him. His love's forever, as we love him first. I wrote 1 Psalm Revelation 2:4, to love, serve, best friend, that's an undying life, L-I-F-E. And an undying life, love, L-O-V-E. All others in dies forever, and his life is forever, as we live our lives born through him. Spiritual truth and righteously, his words of truth, ways and will, the right choices and ways. Eternal within him forever and our eternal home. God himself is my witness, and God himself is my witness, and it through him and his words of truth are valid. This is God's truth. Amen. There. Okay, now this week's children's lesson is for everyone's love. Now there are many different kinds of love. Brother and sister love, father and mother love, sons and daughters love, spouse and husband's love, etc. But there's only one true love, is God's love. His is before and above all others. God himself is the first one for us to love, because he first loved us as our God. We are to love him first. Amen. Revelation 2:4. That's an undying love, L-O-V-E, like I've been teaching you to love, serve first. That's an undying life born through him. Amen. His love is faithful, unfailing, and everlasting. Remember that, never ends, lasts forever. His God's love, peace, joy, etc. lives in us. Galatians 5:20-26. It's an undying life, L-I-F-E. Spiritual rights, truth, which is saying, do the right things, choice, truth, please, words, teaching, language, wills, and ways, and treasures. And temple and light that lives in us and throughout eternity within God himself forever. But when you put the things and people first to love and serve, they are idols, sins, and lies. That saying, the wrong choices. And you're failing your life itself. They end dying, the death and darkness forever, buying from them, and those deaths forever. So always love God himself first. I've been teaching you as a rope for love, etc. Like I've been teaching you, who's unseen spiritual, to let serve our best friend, etc. Like I've been teaching over and over and over again, righteously, spiritually. spiritually, righteously, truthfully, God's words of truth, ways, and well, and have God's love, life, home, temple, light, treasures that's forever with God himself, amen, forever. Okay, now listen to this short story. Listen to this short story. Let's say you are in charge of 100 sheep and one out of the got out of the fence. Home. Would you go and try to find the one that got out and is lost? What would you? When you find the one, don't you feel better knowing the sheep is safe and in the fence and at home? Well, that's how we are here if we don't have Christ Jesus, our shepherd and savior, who gave himself, died and suffered and rose on Easter for us in our sins and our lives. When you choose the things of people instead of him, you become and feel unsafe, lost, buying from them you did. Wolves, idolaters are out there to devour us, buying from the sins, idols, lies, darkness, and death. God protects us and shields us, total non-former God, Ephesians 6:10-17. Do it from them, so we'll say and do the right things and choices run through him. God's love, peace, joy, etc. lives in us, Galatians 5:22-26, through the Spirit, so we don't become devoured, that devour from the wolves, sins, and lies, darkness, and death. Let Jesus Christ find you and bring you back home, pouring through him to lust and bone, to live on through soil. You have Jesus Christ, our shepherd, savior, to turn home with him and feel safe and secure forever with him. Amen. So remember that in our eternal home. Okay, now let's pray. Father, who art in heaven, hallowed be thy name, thy kingdom come, thy will be done on earth as it is in heaven. Give us this day our daily bread, forgive us our trespasses, we forgive those trespass against us. Lead us not to temptation, but deliver us from evil, for thine is the kingdom, the power, and the glory forever. Amen. So ask yourself, whose reflection do you see and go by to live on through? Your own yourself's reflection, buying from who and what saying? Did you go by and flesh someone's desires to love, serve? You're dying, and darkness has you. Then you say and do them lies, and utter sinner and liar. You are worldly like them, and death and darkness has you. And it's truly where you end, and in the world's darkness, that's forever by and from them. But if you go by and from who's unseen, God himself, like him, spiritual to live for and through, then you have his light, L-I-G-H-2, to live first, as I've been teaching you over and over and over again, as he first loved and loved us in Revelation 2:4 and spouse, Jeremiah 3:14. The Lord God says, I am your husband's spouse. That's an undying love to live for and through, etc. Like I've been teaching us an undying life, well, L-I-F-E, born through him. Spiritually, truth, being right, just saying, do the right thing, and to his best friend, etc. Like I've been teaching you, that's everlasting, with and in him forever, and our real eternal home. Amen. Okay, I'll repeat myself, so excuse me. I'm working my sermon all way. Okay, everybody, get your Bibles out. Amen. Hope the wind doesn't bother my camera recorder. I'm pretty sure it's coming from that way again. And I'm trying to sit in the sun because it's a little cold in the shade a little bit. It's 10 degrees. Colder than it was last week, amen. You today, a blessing and a curse. The blessing if you obey the commands, the next 20 I'm giving you today, and a curse, the curse if you disobey the commands. Have the Lord your God turn from the way. I command you today and fall, worship other gods, idols, sins, lies. You are cursed by and from them, amen. You are, you're cursed by and from them. And you will die by and from them, amen. Excuse me. Oh, wow. It's nice in the sun. Amen. Psalm 36. Go to Psalm 36. Psalm's like a poem or song. Amen. An article of words of God's truth is written within my heart. Was it an article of words of God's true words? It's within my heart. God's left concerning the sinful of the wicked, sinful and idolaters. There is no fear of God, no there isn't, before the person's eyes. For in the person's own eyes, the person flatters the person's self too much to detect and hate the person's saying. The words of the person's mouth are sins and idols, lies, and deceitful. The person ceases to be wise and to do good for unto God, even on the person's bad, bad, bad. The person plots evil, evil, evil. The person commits the person's self to a sinful course, by in front of them, and does not reject what is wrong. By in front of them, your love, O Lord, reaches to the heavens. Your faithfulness to the skies, your rightness like the mighty mountains, your justice like the great day. O Lord, you preserve both people and base. How priceless is your unfailing love. Those high and low bone people find refuge in the shadow of your wings. They feast in the abundance of your house. You give them drink from your river of delight. For with you is the fountain of life in your light. LIGHT, we see light in him. Amen. Continue your love to those who know you. Your righteousness is to the upright and heart by God's love. May the foot of the proud not come against me, nor the hands of the wicked sinful idolaters drive me away. See how the evildoer sinful idolaters lie fallen, thrown down, not able to rise, will die forever. Amen, amen. There, they will die forever. Okay, Psalm 68. Well, this one's long. He's giving me a lot of Bible verses. He really keeps me busy. Amen. May God arise to his enemies. He scattered the sinful and idolaters. May his foes flee before him as smoke is blown away by the wind. May you blow them away, Lord God, as wax melts before the fire. May the wicked sinful and idolaters, liars, perish, die before God. May the righteous be glad and rejoice before God, and may they be happy and joyful. Galatians 5:26, God's love is joy, except for his spirit. Sing to God, sing praise by God's love to his name, extol him who rides on the clouds. His name is the Lord, and rejoice before him, a father to the fatherless and defender of widows. His God in his holy dwelling, God sets lonely and families. He leads forth the prisoners with singing. But to the rebellious that are against God, lives in a sun-scorched land, will die forever. When you went out before your people, O God, when you marched through the waste of land, the earth shook, the heavens poured down the rain. Before God, the one of sin, before God, the God of Israel, you gave abundant showers, O God. You refreshed your weary inheritance, your people settled in it. And from your bounty, O God, you provided for the poor, the Lord announced the true word, and great was the company of those rulers who proclaim it. Of those who proclaim it, kings, rulers, and armies, people flee in haste. In the camps meet people, divide the plunder, even while you sleep among the campfires. The wings of my doves are sheeted with silver, its feathers were shining gold. King's rulers and the lion, it was less snow falling on Zelman. The mountains of Russian magic, mountains, rugged mountains, they gazed. Oh, rugged mountains, the mountains where God chose to reign. Where the Lord God himself will dwell forever. The chariots of God are just tens of thousands, and thousands of thousands. The Lord has come from his sanctuary. When you ascend on high, you led captives in your twine. You receive gifts from people, even from the rebellious that are against God. That you, O Lord God, will dwell there. Praise be to God our Savior, who daily bears our burden, our God, a God who saves. For and through him, for the seven Lord comes, escape from death. Surely God will crush the heads of his enemies, sinful idolaters. And here it comes to those who go in their sins. The Lord says, I will bring them from Bashan. I will bring them from the depths of the sea, that you may plunder, feed in the blood of your foes' enemies, while the tongues of your doves have their share. Your procession has come into view, O God, the procession of my God, King, into the sanctuary. In front of the singers after them, the musicians with their flame tambourine. Praise God in the great congregation. Praise the Lord in the assembly of Israel, where as we am, there's great throng. Your power, O God. Show us your strength, O God, as you have done before. Because of your temple in Jerusalem, kings will bring you gifts, rebuke the beasts among the raisins of both calves of the nation, on both that bring bars, silver nations. And God will come from Egypt, crush, must submit herself to God. Sing to God, Oh, kingdoms everywhere of the earth, sing. Sing praise to the Lord, to Him who rides on ancient skies, skies above. Yes, He will. He will ride on skies above. Who thunders with mighty voice. Yes, He does. Proclaim the power of God, His majesty over Israel. His power's in the skies. You are awesome, O God, in your sanctuary. The God of Israel gives power and strength to His people. Praise be to God. Amen. Yes, He does. Amen, amen. He's our strength, and unto Him your sins and idols, all your weaknesses, sicknesses, and death and darkness flying from them. Amen. Psalm 106. Wow, He's giving me a lot of Bible verses. He really keeps me busy. Amen. I'll read that one next week. He's giving me a lot of Bible verses. Amen there. Remember Daniel in the lion's den, Daniel 6, his strong faith in God protect him from lions. Amen there, so don't forget that. Amen, amen. And Jonah tried to run away from God, so God had a giant fish to swallow him for 3 days and nights until Jonah prayed to God for forgiveness, and the giant fish spit him out into dry land. Amen. Never try to flee or hide from God. You can't hide or lie to from Him. It's impossible. He's everywhere spiritually. He knows where your heart. He knows where your heart and your minds are. Who wants you to listen and worship here and you live your life for Him through. That's where you're going in on His eternal judgment day. Amen, amen there. So remember that. To love life and light to Him is His faithful and righteous. Or the sinful and idolaters will die forever. Amen, amen. He's giving me a lot of Bible verses. I don't know if I'm going to get all these done. Amen. He brought me to Zechariah 8. I don't know if we ever read Zechariah. Okay, everybody, go to Zechariah 8. Again, the word of the Lord Almighty came to me. This is what the Lord Almighty says. I am jealous for Zion. I am burning with jealous for her. This is what the Lord says. I will return to Zion, Mount Zion at the end of time. Dwell in Jerusalem, His new holy city at the end of time. Then Jerusalem will be called the city of Truth. And the mountain of the Lord Almighty will be called the Holy Mountain. Amen. This is what the Lord Almighty says. Once again, men and women, the Bible way, sit in the streets of Jerusalem, each with pain hangings because of his age. See, streets will be filled with boys and girls playing there. This is what the Lord Almighty says. To the remnant of His people at this time, but will seem marvelous to me, declares the Lord Almighty. This Lord Almighty says, I will save my people from the countries of the east and the west, and I will bring them back to live in Jerusalem. They will be my people, righteous people, and I will be faithful and righteous to them as their God. That's what the Lord Almighty says. You who hears these words spoken by the prophets who were there when fountains. The temple may be built, amen. Before that time, there will be no wages for men or beasts. No one could go about the person's business save because of the person's enemy. For I had turned every person against the person's neighbor. But now I will not deal with the remnant of this people as I did in the past, declares the Lord Almighty. The seed will grow well, the vine will yield its fruit, the ground will produce its crops, and the heavens will drop the dew. I will give all these things and inheritance and remnant of this people. As for you have been an object of cursing among the nations, O Judah and Israel, for I will save you and you will be a blessing. Do not be afraid, but let your hands be strong. This was Lord Almighty said, just as I had determined to bring disaster upon you and show no pity when you were Father, anger me, bind from your sins, idols, lies, says the Lord Almighty. So now I have determined to do good again, Jerusalem, Judea. Amen. Do not be afraid. There are things you will do. You are to do. Speak the truth. Speak the truth through and for God to each other, born through God Himself, and render true and sound judgment in your courts. Do not plot evil, sins, idols, lies against your neighbor, and do not love to swear falsely. I hate all this, declares the Lord Almighty. Again, the word of the Lord Almighty came to us, the Lord says. The fast 4th, 5th, and 7th, and 10th months will become joy, joyful, glad, patient, happy, festival, Judah. Therefore, I love truth and peace, for unto God, that's what the Lord Almighty says, many people, inhabitants of many cities will yet come, and inhabitants of the city will be one another to say, let us go, once to enter, to retreat and treat. The Lord, seek the Lord Almighty. I myself am going, and many people and powerful nations will come to Jerusalem to seek the Lord Almighty and to entreat I am. That's what the Lord Almighty says. And in those days, 10 men from the Mountain Language Nation will take hold on one Jew by the hand. Let's go with you because we have heard that God is with you. Excuse me, I got to tickle my throat. Excuse me.
Trespass if we men,
the many died, I trust especially the one man. How much more did God's grace and the gift that came by the grace of one man, Jesus Christ, overflow to me? Again, the gift of God. God is not like the result of one man's sin. Excuse me, I need another drink. My allergies are acting up. Like I said, ravioli's blooming again. Excuse me. Condemnation, which is death. But the gift of many trespasses brought justification, for us by trespassing one man, death reigned through that one man much more, where those who receive God's abundant position of gratification, the gift of righteousness, reign in life through the one man, Jesus Christ, consequently, just as a result of one trespass condemned to all men, people. Excuse me. So also the result of one act of righteousness was justification, excuse me, that brings our life for all people. For just as though the disobedience to God of the one man, the many, was made sinners, so also through the obedience of one man, Jesus Christ, the many will be made righteous through him. And you give your sins to him, and pray to him, and let him die. Let us follow him, and live your life through him, and his words truth. Amen. The law was added so that trespass might increase, or when so sin increased, grace increased all the more, so that sin reigns in death, so that grace might reign. Through righteousness to bring eternal life and into God with through Christ Jesus our Lord. Through Christ Jesus our Lord. Amen. Okay, he brought me to this one. I haven't read this one for a while. Excuse me, my nose is running. My allergies are bad. Excuse me. Pardon me. Spirit of God and into God. I am pretty sorry and see some anguish in my heart, for I could wish that I was a prisoner of Christ, so for the sake of my brothers, for those unraised, the people of Israel, those whose adoption as sons, their divine glory, the covenant, the receiving the law, the temple, worship, and the promise. There is patriarchs in front of them, trace of human ancestry of Christ, who is God over all, forever praising man for this. God's word had failed, for not all who descend from Israel are Israel, nor because they are his descendants are all Abraham's children. No. On the contrary, it is through Isaac that your offspring will be reckoned. In other words, it is not the natural children who are God's children, but as children of the promise, who are regarded as Abraham's offspring. For this was the promise was stated at the point in time I returned Sarah Hamilton. Now I saw Rebecca's children, Isaac, you have twins born. You went good or bad in order of God's promise, elect might stand. Election might stand not by works, but by him who calls. She was told the older servant young, just as is written, Jacob I loved, Ishmael I hated by his actions and sayings. What then shall we say? Is God unjust? Not at all, for he says to Moses, I will have mercy on whom I will have mercy, and I will have compassion on whom I will have compassion. It does not therefore depend on one person's desire or effort, but on God's mercy, for the scripture says to Pharaoh, I raised you up for this very purpose, that I might display my power in you, that my name might be proclaimed in all the earth. Therefore, God has mercy on whom he wants to have mercy, and he hardens whom he wants to harden. What if you say to me then, and why does God still blame us for one resist his will? Who are you, O person, to talk back to God? Who are you? Who are you, O person, to talk back to God? Show what is formed by form, say to him, who formed it, why did you make me like this? Does not the potter have the right to make out of the same lump of clay some for the noble purpose and some for common use? What if God choose to show his wrath and make his power known, for with great patience the objects of his wrath prepared for destruction, which is death forever? What if he did this to make the riches of his glory known to the objects of his mercy, prepared with advance for glory, even as whom he has called not only for the Jews, but also from the Gentiles who love and serve money or serve Shemorrow, as for he says, Hosea. I will call them my people, not my people, and I will call her my loved one, but not my loved one. And said, it will happen in the very place where it shall be said, you are not my people, and it will be called sons of the living God, children. Isaiah cried out concerning Israel, though the number of the Israelites be like the sand of the sea, only the memory of the same. For the Lord will carry out his sentence on the earth with speed and finality. It is just as Isaiah said previously, unless the Lord Almighty had left us descendants, we would have become like Saddam. We have become like Gomorrah, rebellious. They're against God, such immoral, and they mock heavenly beings, spiritual beings. What shall we say then, that the Gentiles that love and serve money are such immoral, who did not pursue righteousness, have obtained a righteousness by faith, but Israel, who pursued by law righteousness, has not obtained it? Why not? Because they pursue it by, not by faith, but as it were by what words. They stumbled over the stumbling stones written. See, I lay in Zion a stone that causes people to stumble, and a rock that makes them fall, and the one who trusts in him, and the one who trusts in him will never be put to shame. Amen, amen. He brought me that one. Excuse me. Apologize here. My allergies all of a sudden start acting up really bad again. Excuse me. Give me a second here. It's part of this week's Galatians 5:19. That's the sinful nature. Since the sinful nature, which are your own self-perseverances, are obvious. Sexual morality, impurity, bawdry attitude, witchcraft, hatred, sword, jealousy, fits of rage, self-ambitions, disordered faction, even unrighteous, and like, warned you like I did before. Those who live like this will not hear eternal life of God, but the fruit of the Spirit is God's love, joy, peace, patience, kindness, goodness, faithfulness, goodness, self-control, against such as no law. Those who belong to Christ Jesus have crucified the sinful nature with his passion desires. Since we live by the Spirit of God, let's keep in step with the Spirit of God. Let's not become conceited, provoking in each other. Amen, amen. Which is life in and through him. Amen. Excuse me. I apologize. My allergies are really acting up bad today. 2 Timothy 3. Pardon me. But mark this. There will be terrible times. The last days, people will be lovers of themselves, lovers of money, boastful, proud, abusive, disobedient to the parents, ungrateful, unholy, without love, unforgiving, slanderous, without self-control, brutal, not lovers of the good, point to God, treacherous, rash, conceited, lovers of pleasure, which are your sins and idols and wants and desires, rather than lovers of God himself, having a form of godlessness, but denying his power, have nothing to do with them. They are the kind that wander away into homes and gain control over weak-willed women who were loaded down with sin, or swayed by all kinds of evil desires, which are their sins and idols. They're always learning, but never able to knowledge the truth of God. No, they don't. Jesus changed them, he's pressing most, so these people press the truth. Yes, they do. Men, they have depraved minds, buying from the sins and idols. Yes, they do. Their minds are depraved. Who was found faith's concern or rejected? Yes, they are. Buying from God, they are. But they will not get very far. In the case of those men, the people, their fall will be curved to everyone. It will be curved to everyone. You have known about my teaching, my way of life, my purpose, faith, patience, love, endurance, persecution, suffering. Yet the Lord rescued me from all of them. In fact, anyone who wants to live a godly life in Christ Jesus will be persecuted. While evil, simple, and idle to people and imposters will go from bad to worse. Yep, they'll go from bad to worse, the simple and idle to as well. Many of what you have learned of God and have become convinced of because you know those from whom you learned it and how from infancy you have known the Holy Scriptures of the Bible, which were able to make you wise for salvation through faith in Christ Jesus. All scriptures is God's breathed and is useful for teaching, rebuking, correcting, and training in righteousness unto God. Amen. So that the person of God may be duly equipped for every good work for unto God Himself. Amen. There, so remember that as well. Remember this as well. Titus 3:10 and 11. Warn a divisive, sinful, and idle to a liar person once, and then warn them again. After that, have nothing to do with the person. You may be sure that the person is self-condemned. In other words, dies forever. Amen, amen. They'll die forever. Okay, he's giving me a lot of Bible verses. Pardon me.
WCIC in Eugene. What is your Sunday routine? Right, so you can go to church.
Okay, now, we're studying on the book of Revelations. The end of time when Christ Jesus comes again. We're in Revelation 16. Excuse me, I need a drink again. Then I heard a loud voice from the temple saying to seven angels, go. Oh, great. Excuse me, pardon me for a second. From hand waxing 2 weeks ago. Revelation 6:10, at the end of time when Christ Jesus comes again. Then I heard a loud voice from the temple saying to seven angels, go, out and pour seven bowls of God's wrath and anger on the earth. The first angel went and poured out his bow on the lion, and ugly and painful sores broke out on the people who had the mark of the beast and worshipped his image. The second angel poured out his bow on the sand and turned to blood like that of a dead man, and every living thing in the sea died. The third angel poured out his bow on the rivers and springs of water, and they became blood. Then I heard the angel in charge of the water saying, you are just in these judgments, you who are and who were the Holy One, because you have so judged. For they have shed the blood of your righteous saints and prophets, for you have given them blood to drink as they deserve. And I heard the altar respond, yes, Lord God Almighty, true and just are your judgments. The fourth angel poured out his bow on the sun, and the sun was given power to scorch people with fire. They were seared by the intense heat, and they cursed the name of God, who had control over these plagues. But they refused to repent. No, they refused to repent from their sins, idols, lies, and to glory Him. No, they didn't. They wouldn't. The fifth angel poured out his bow on the throne of the beast, and his kingdom was plunged to darkness. Men gnawed their teeth in agony and cursed God of heaven because of their pains and their sores, but they refused to repent. They refused to repent their sins, idols, and lies of what they have done. The sixth angel poured out his bow on the great river, Euphrates, and the water was dried up, to clear the way for the kingdoms from the east. Then I saw three evil spirits that looked like frogs. They came out of the mouth of the dragon, the mouth of the beast, and the mouth of the false prophet. They are spirits of demons performing miraculous signs, and they go out kings of the whole world to gather them in the battle of the great day. At the end of time when he comes again. Of God the Almighty, behold, I come like a thief. Blessed is the person who stays awake and keeps the purse closed with the person, so that the person may not go naked and be shamefully exposed. Then they gather the kings together. To the place the Hebrews call Armageddon. Remember this. The seven angel poured out his bow into the air, and out of the temple came a loud voice. And the gong saying is done. Then came a flash of light and rumbling peals of thunder. Severe earthquake, no earthquake like this has ever occurred since on earth. So tremendous was the quake. The great city split to three parts, and the cities and the nations collapsed. God remembered Babylon the Great and gave her the cup filled with the wine of the very great anger of his wrath. Every island fled away, and the mountains could not be found. From the sky, huge hailstones above 100 pounds, each fell upon people, and they cursed God on account of the plagues of hail, because foreign spouse, Jim, Matthew 14, God says, I am your husband's spouse, as he first loved, loved us. Remember that he first loved, loved us. Amen. That's an undying love. Jeremiah 3:14. To serve be mastered by from 16:13-15, excuse me. The best friend to live on through, that's an undying life, L-I-F-E, spiritual, righteous, and truthfully. To say and do the right things and choice on through. His words are to teaching language, will and wise. The fruit of the Spirit, which by 2020 is God's love, which joy of some is in you. And he's our strength, amen, for doing from our tribulations, sins, and idols, lies that comes at us all the time, put on the former of God, Ephesians 6:10-17, to save you the right things, choice, and obey and obey from his 10 commandments. Exodus 20, the first one is, God says, you shall have no other God idol before me to worship. That's an idol, sin, and lie. Sicknesses and weaknesses that cause death and darkness, turn away from them. So remember that. We are to worship, love, serve, follow, to live on through spiritual righteously. And truthfully, God himself. And have his love, life, light, him from home, treasures, promises, turn with God himself, amen. Now take him to house, spouse for yourself, and I'm picking to work 4 to 5 hours a week, and I'm having to work hard, I can use as an idol. And I'm for comes true friends. My number purpose of my organization is to preach the gospel, the real God's truth, amen. Of the Holy Bible, to preach the gospel of the Holy Bible, God's truth, and his kingdom, eternal life, and save his people and tribe. Number two, help people. Number three, help make our community and state a better, safe place to live. I've emailed Governor J.B. Fletcher, Peoria, and East Peoria some issues. I'm working on them. And they are working on the roads and bridges that needs fixed. And I want to thank them for them. They are appreciated for us and our safety and our automobiles from the potholes in the roads, amen, there. And I'm working on the issues for our community, okay, now. I'm picking up trash in my neighborhood, so please pick up trash in your neighborhood to help keep it clean from trash debris. Thanks, God bless you, for, okay, I want to thank area businesses, pastors, organizations, police, and fire departments for what you do for our community, the River Plex for my mental, physical, social health, and OSF there. And for Furious Parson District for letting me use the riverfront to preach and sing on Sundays and sing afterwards. When it's between 60 and 90 degrees, excuse me, my allergies up and my nose itches. Outside, weather permits, and there's no events at the reception building that's up there. That's at the main entrance way. It'll be on the side when I'm there along here. But I'm okay now. I'm an ordained pastor. So you can need my services. You can email me. It's on the side, number 724. Okay, so I'm also watching my sermons on the Wi-Fi. Okay, now the holidays are coming. The holidays are coming up. So I'll let you know things. I know them. Okay, now in Peoria, you can get a light put up in your backyard through the city for free. At least they did a few years ago for safety. Okay, now I'm passing out flyers and putting them on automobiles. Okay, now. Touch-up painting. I'm doing touch-up painting. Amen. Me starting my fall cleaning, too. I don't want to, but I got to. Okay, now, kids can vote for free. Go on kidsvotefree.com for coupons. Okay, now, you can donate Bibles. Go on lovepackages.org where to send them. Okay, now, in our community, there's a lot to do. Go on your city site on events. WCIC site events, libraries, gyms, museums, zoos, etc. There's a lot to do in our community. Okay, now on this side, you can download some of my songs. All that more soon. I've just gotten at the computer a few months ago in recording studio, and it's a lot of work. I have to record the music and the songs separately, then I have to put them together, and then pick out the best ones, so excuse me there. They're a lot of work. They really are. And I preach and sing every week and try and write a new song. For donations, I've taught you on teas and offerings. We are to give a tenth of our money and things every month to the Lord. Well, you're robbing God and his cars, Deuteronomy 14, 22-23, Malachi 3:8-9. Thanks if you donate. God bless you for it. And Missing Children, Central Illinois, they're also on the site. If you have any information, call your police department. Pray for them and their families in Peoria, Illinois. Illinois, a 16-year-old boy was shot in a serious condition for him and his family. Northern Texas, Dallas, tornadoes for the victims. Memphis, Tennessee, severe weather to the Mid-South for the victims. Springfield, Missouri's severe storms for the victims. Florida's tornadoes for the victims. Tropical storms and hurricanes for the victims. There's so many of them, I can't keep up with them. Dan, Pastor Dice, Paul's wife, Joe, David, and May have health problems. Robin, Heather, John, Don, Ron, Donald, and his girlfriend, and 24 and 25-year-old daughters, they are going through something personal. Our president, rulers of our state and cities, ISIS war, pray and give thanks in the morning, at meals, and at night before you go to bed. My organization, songs and novels are written to find a publisher. Amen. Amen there. Excuse me. I have two publishers I need to call back. They left me a message, and I've gotten busy all week. It went by fast. Amen there. Okay, now, no one said, saying and doing the right things, choices from the Christ Jesus would be easy to love and serve, best friend, to live for and through righteousness, virtue, and truthfully. That I eternal within in him, and I return home, treasures, temple, and promise. Amen there. Okay, now. May the love, peace, joy, life, light, temple, home, treasures, righteousness, spirit, words, true teaching, language, salvation, Christ, glory, and promise of God being with you all. And be ready for Jesus' eternal judgment day, true, and kingdom's near to his faithful and righteous, eternal love, life, and light with him. Or to the sinful night unto his death and darkness forever. And as faithful and righteous are building God's foundation, home, temple, city, kingdom, people, tribe, promise, formed through God's treasures of his love. get to be on the river for a minute. The weather's supposed to really change, so it's supposed to get pretty cold by Wednesday. So anyway, well, you know the weather is, it's changeable. It's like a roller coaster ride. You don't know what it's going to do. So anyway, and I want to apologize. I think that car that was here last week, I think they wanted to hear me sing. If they would have stuck around a little longer, I would have stayed here and sung. That's another thing I wanted to do. I told my son to put on there after I'm done preaching and stuff, I'd stay here and sing.